Yes,
Good.
sir.
Now, I want to continue our second chapter now. Okay, then the next one. Okay, this is the operationalization and measurement. And we have again two key questions here. How to measure the reality, which could be abstract or ambiguous, and what are the level of measurement? Because of time limiting, you can read some of the slides, or you can find all slides on my web page. Therefore, maybe sometimes I will jump to chapters, another chapters. To the outline for this chapter, we will discuss about the conceptualization and then operationalization and level of measurement. If I am asking to you, what is a measurement? Who can answer to this question? What do you think about measurement? If I am telling to you, make a measurement about a subject, what do you understand from this question?
Maybe by the subject.
Your voice is not so clear.
Okay.
Maybe Tuana, do you have any idea? Tuana's connection is better, I think, eh?
Your voice is not coming, Doctor.
Your voice is not coming,
Hello, I
Doctor.
am
Hello.
listening to you.
But your Doctor, your voice
But
is
your
very, very
Doctor, your
low
voice
and
is
interrupted
very,
for me.
very low and
I can't
interrupted
hear
for
you
me.
properly.
I
I
can't
see,
hear you
but
properly.
your voice is excellent, really, believe me. I am listening to you excellent now. Okay, measurement is that careful, deliberate observations of the real world for the purpose of describing objects and events in terms of attributes composing the variable. For example, political party affiliation, age, satisfaction with college. These are variables that we can measure. For example, we can apply a survey to the public, and first of all, we can ask the age of the people. And if they are going to the college, then we can ask some questions related to the satisfaction with the college. These are the measurement and variables. Measuring anything that exists, concept and construct. Concepts are construct derived by mutual agreement from mental images. Conceptions summarize collection or simply related observation and experiences. For example, we can directly observe the gender, age, height, eyes color, etc. Okay, you can see me now, I think, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, I see.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I see.
Okay, we continue.
Doctor, we can't see slide like this.
Doctor, we can't see slide like
Yes,
this.
I will bring again the slides.
Doctor, you asked about, I think,
Doctor, you
measurement.
asked
Yes,
about, I think,
collecting a
measurement.
part of the
It's
research,
about
reporting
collecting a
part of
part
the
of the
research
research,
paper.
reporting a
Yes,
part of the
correct.
research
Do you have
paper.
any idea about it?
It's about collecting
It's
a part
about
of the reporting
collecting a part
research.
of the reporting research.
For example, if you want to do a research, what should you do the first, in the first step? Tuana? Yes.
The first
Understand
you
the
should
fundamental of the research.
understand the
What you
fundamental
all do.
of the
Yes, this
research.
is the first
What
step.
you all
Very
do.
good. And
Yes.
next,
Second step, understand
Yes.
the type of
Second
the
step,
measurement.
understand the
Yes, you
type
have
of the
to
measurement.
decide about the measurement types. which types of measurement will be more suitable for your research? What next?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Don't worry to speak. You know, just try to say what you want, and it is not important to make some mistakes or give wrong answers. It is important to discuss about issues together, because thanks to advanced technology, we can make this type of the conversation together in virtual environment. Okay, what is the construct? Constructs measured by a scale that is created by combining several direct or indirect observables, such as individuals' attitude toward abortion, trust, loyalty. I mean, it depends on the type of your research. For example, if you want to know how the people live in a district of your country, then you will prepare a special questions for them. I mean, maybe you will try to learn about the demographic situation of the people, and then you have to prepare questions where you can collect data. Okay, conceptualization. This is the process through which we specify what we mean when we use particular terms in research. We cannot meaningfully answer a question without a working agreement about the meaning of the outcome. And conceptualization produces a specific agreed upon meaning for a concept for the purpose of research. This is just the information what I am providing in this slide to you about the conceptualization. It means there are items which are related to concept of your research. Okay, for conceptualization, we have some definitions, and in exam, sometimes I am giving some keywords, and on the other hand, you can see some definitions, and I can ask, match the following, for example. For example, I can give indicator, and what do you understand when we are discussing about the indicator? Then you have to select the answer and observation that we choose to consider as a reflection of a variable we wish to study. For example, public safety, violent crimes per 100,000 population, wealth of a country. And then we have another definition for it, dimension. This is a specificable aspect of a concept. Love, communication, trust, attraction can be given as example for dimensions. And social capital, this is trust, social trust, interracial trust, diversity of friendship. Okay, here you see there are four keywords: conceptualization, nominal definition, operational definition, and real world measurement. On the right side, you see the definitions of these items. For example, for conceptualization, the process through which concepts are made more specific. And nominal definition means the definition that is simply assigned to a term without any claim that the definition represents a real entity. And operational definition means specifies precisely how a concept will be measured. Okay, you see, if we are handling with measurement system, this part of the research is called operational definition. And real world measurement means use the measurement to observe that real world. For example, we are in a room and we want to measure the temperature of a room. What should we do? The first step is we should think about the environment. We should look for a thermometer to measure the temperature. As soon as we found a thermometer and we brought this thermometer in the room, in a corner, and we are measuring of the temperature of the room. And you see the degree, the temperature is 22 degrees Celsius. And my question is that, will you trust this result or do you have some other ways or methods to validate it? What do you think about that? If you have something in your mind, please do not hesitate to answer.
Yes.
Yes.
What can we say?
Yes.
Yes.
I have two ways.
I have two ways.
First of all, I can take maybe the measurement. I can specify the number of times of which I'm going to measure the temperature.
Not that, mm-hmm. not just the first time.
I can go for it.
First of all, you will measure it and maybe 10 minutes later you will check it again, etc. with time interval. But the question is,
yes.
it is validation of the measurement. Do you trust this measurement or not? You can accept it directly. Okay, the 22 Celsius is correct. The temperature of the room is 22 degrees.
After going for the trials, maybe for the third and fourth, if I'm getting the same result, then it can convince me that I can trust.
Okay, Tuana, do you have any opinion for it? Do you have something in your mind? Or Saber, do you have something to tell it? And do you have something to, in your mind? Will you trust what you measure from thermometer or not?
I'll trust what.
You should say, first of all, we have to be sure that our thermometer is measuring correctly. Because there is a thermometer, but you are not sure about it. Because this is an instrument. And therefore, I suggest you to find another thermometer and compare them. The results should be compared. And both results, if both results are the same, then you can say, okay, yes, the temperature of the room is 22 Celsius degrees. Then you can agree with the validation.
Doctor,
yes, Tamara.
Doctor,
you'll be sure about thermometer.
You'll be sure about thermometer. Change the room.
Has the same
reading or not? For example, if the thermometer it doesn't give us the same reading or give us the same thing, it will not be changed for some places. It's cold or some places it's hot. That means the temperature is not working well. Or we can bring another thermometer. We'll make a compare together and we'll read we see the reader for both of the thermometers.
In this way we will know which one is working and which one has a quality, which one has not quality.
But you know the conditions of the environment is very are very important. Assume you are measuring temperature next to window. On the other hand, you are measuring a corner where climate system is working. Yes, Victor.
I told you before something. We tried the thermometer in our building. We saw the thermometer had the same reading in every room, in every environment. So we realized this thermometer not working well. If the thermometer gives constantly temperature, we know the thermometer is not working well. It's dependent on the weather condition, environment condition, but also
it's dependent on the quality. Your answer is correct. Okay, now again, the course content. Now, a study on, for example, we want to make a study in the field of social class. And for doing this research, for conceptualization, we can say, we can ask the following question. What are the different meanings and dimensions of the concepts of social class? What is the social class? First of all, we have to think this issue, and then we should create our questions related to this subject. And then for nominal definition for social class, we can say for this study, we will define social class as representing economic differences, specifically income, etc. And for operational definition, measure economic differences via individuals' annual income before taxes last year. And for real world measurement, we can say conduct a survey and ask individuals a question. What was your annual income before taxes last year? This type of the questions can be asked for determine the wealthy issues of the people, and this is a way to make a research in the social class. Operationalization is the development of specific research procedures that will result in empirical observations representing those concepts in the real world. Empirical observation means you are gathering some mathematical formulas and you are using some methods and you are mixing them. And empirical means which is related to mathematics. And use variables and attributes. Variables means, for example, you are applying a survey in a student group, and in this room there are female and male. Then you want to ask about gender, then you have to put a question related to gender. On the other hand, because of your research, you want to follow internet usage or social media usage by the people or students, and you want to compare with the age. I mean, whether or not the old plays roles on the results. And then students, these are the attributes, gender, age, etc. Every variable must have two important qualities. Attributes must be exhaustive and attributes must be mutually exclusive. It means the attributes what you are looking for should be exhaustive. Exhaustive means it should be declared clearly. Everything should be explained clearly. Attributes must be mutually exclusive. Everything should be explained clearly, not implication, just explicitly should be explained. Okay, now this topic is important. We are going to discuss about the level of measurement. There are actually four layer of measurements. The nominal and ordinal level of measurements are categorized as categorical variables. On the other hand, we have interval and ratio level of measurement. For nominal level of measurement, we can give this example. For example, you are applying a survey to your students, and then you are asking about the religion of the students. And a student can answer only one answer, unique one answer. Nobody can say, I am 30% Muslim, 25% Protestant, etc. And therefore, if you are asking a question and if you get only one response about your question, then it is categorized as nominal level of measurement. Do you understand? Did you understand the meaning of the nominal?
Can you repeat, Doctor?
Yes, I am repeating again.
Can you repeat, Doctor?
Assume you are preparing a survey about the preferences of the religion issues of your students. You want to know who in your room, which kind of the religious is having. And for example, if I am asking to a student, what is your religion? He will say, my religion is, for example, Muslim or Catholic or Protestant. It is not possible to get more than one answer from the same person. I mean, nobody can say, okay, I am 30% Muslim, on the other hand, 25% Catholic. It is not possible.
That's unique answer is available.
One answer.
Yes. For example, if you ask a question related to gender, you will get again nominal level of
male gender. Or female or third gender.
Yes. Male or female. You cannot get another answer for it.
Yes.
Ordinal means here. Now ordinal, I am speaking about the ordinal level of measurement. For example, assume I have a question as following. Dr. Varol is teaching well. This is an opinion of a person or a view of a person. And then there are five ranks for it. For example, the first one, strongly agree, neutral, disagree, strongly disagree. You see, I rank them. There are stages.
You mean you make probability?
Yes, level for it. We are having strongly agree, neutral, disagree, or strongly disagree. This type of level of measurement is called ordinal level of measurement. There are you can create. Yes, sorry, I am listening to you,
Doctor,
now.
It is not calling questionnaire.
In the questionnaire, you can say. For example, you can make questions about.
Agree, strongly disagree.
You can do that.
Yes.
Or you can make very well, well, good, etc. You see, you can make stages. And if this type of the answer you want to see, then you have to create ordinal level of measurement. For example, in statistics, Likert measurement, five Likert measurement means there are five possible answers available. What about the interval? Interval means, actually we can give your grading system for it. For example, if I ask about your grade in a course, then if you say my grade is 95 point, then I will say, okay, you did well and your grade is A. You know, on the other hand, if we are discussing about a grade which is located between 80 and 89, You see, every time I am speaking about interval, and the grading system of the student is a good example for understanding of the interval level of measurement. Everybody understood?
Yes, sir.
I just want to ask maybe the steps to conduct that research.
Because I had you talk about the processes the steps one has to follow to conduct a particular research.
But due to the internet connection, I couldn't get it right.
Understand.
So I'm sorry for
the step of the research. Exactly. Should I come back and explain it again?
Yes, sir, because I just now got the internet connection, it's very strong now. Initially, I have been left behind.
Okay, I understand you. For research process, in this table, you see, there are 9 steps. And your question maybe will be following every time this 9 steps should be followed. No, it depends on the type of your research. But normally, in most cases, you follow these steps. First of all, you will define the research problem. What you want to search, what you want to investigate. It should be in the first step.
Yes.
And what is your purpose? What is your purpose doing this research? And do you want to do a research just for exploratory or descriptive? Just you will make some description or explanatory. These are the methods of a research. You can use one of them or combine, mix.
Sorry,
Victor. Yes, Tuana.
Victor, can we instead say purpose, what's your target for this research?
As you mentioned, purpose can be under
your target, your goal.
Mostly you will investigate about your research project. For example, Tuana, you are PhD student, and you will select a topic for your research. And maybe a part of your research will be based on the survey. And this survey will be used for helping for your findings and clarification of your topics. And therefore, what I am showing to you here as steps can be varied because of the method or because of the research topics. Okay, then conceptualization means specify the meanings of each concept you want to study. Just you will clarify. You will say, okay, I am investigating this topic. And the concept is that. And then for research methods, you have to select. As you see here, there are some research methods. You can do experiments. You can do survey research. Okay, here. Survey research. You can do field research. Survey is the best one. You can prepare an online survey. Field research means you can go to the field and ask the people on the street, on the home, etc. Content analysis, after you define the content and border your content, then you have to analyze them and you can to compare, etc. Maybe there are already some research and you have data in your hand, especially if you will prepare your thesis in the field of machine learning, then probably you will use some data sets. You will have data sets in your hand. And you can use this existing data results for your research. Comparative research means there are some results and you are comparing these results and you are adding your ideas about this comparative, about the research. You can say, okay, this researcher claims this way, the other researcher claims this way. After I analyze these two ideas, my opinion in this way. This is comparative. Yes,
it is not a review, but maybe you
can do additional experiment.
Yes, for example, you have your thesis.
Yes, for example, you have your thesis
and write your result and
bring the other results. You will compare and you will say your idea about them and yours. What's different? What you will do? What's the
your why you have this type?
You have this type. Another time you have just write a review. For example, you bring 10 pages. You write your idea. For example, this author do this, and another author did this. The result author better than this one.
Actually,
it's not the same you spoke about.
Means we cannot say reviewing is comparing. Reviewing is comparing too, but sometimes you can add additional research on it too. You can add some more research into this concept, and you can comment all of them together. And therefore, what you are seeing here, comparative research means you are comparing the results, your results, and other results together. And evaluation, actually, evaluation is related to comparative too. For evaluation, there are some ideas from other researchers, and you are evaluating all of them together. As you see, these research methods cannot be distinguished exactly, because all of them are connected to each other. Sometimes you will use survey research where you can make comparative research too. And it doesn't mean, okay, in survey, just you are asking your question without making any analyze or etc. It is not the research. Okay? Okay, now again here.
Yes. Sir,
yes.
Maybe questions?
Some research are not complete.
They have some kind of limitations
example,
in their research.
Can I use that if I can overcome those limitations as my research?
Maybe somebody conducted maybe
laboratory system,
online,
for example, but he has some
laboratory system, for example,
research.
But he has some limitations is in on research.
Use his research
can
if I can overcome those
use his
research
if
as
I
my
can
research.
Overcome those
Biliano,
limitations as my research.
Before you decide about your research, you should think about the available instruments, lab issues, etc. together. I mean,
yes.
You are trying to make an investigation related to technical subject, but in your lab, there isn't any instrument about this subject. And therefore, you should not select this topic, or then you have to demand some instruments that you can measure it. Before you make an investigation, I suggest you make a list. First of all, what I am looking for. This is first question for you. And then you should say, okay, which kind of the instruments should I use for this research? Can I find these instruments easily in my institutions or in other institutions? Everything should be taught clearly. Otherwise, you can make a project, but because lack of the instruments, etc., you cannot go further, and you have to interrupt your research.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Please pay attention to this issue.
Yes.
Yes. And then,
thank you. Thank you.
Population and sampling. What is the population and sampling? This is so we can think about the election system. As when last year in Turkey we had election of the governors, and the some companies who did surveys on the field did estimation about the results. But when they did this type of the research, they established small groups from each cities. For example, from Elazığ, from Istanbul, Ankara, etc. They collected some data using the telephone, etc. And then they wanted to make an estimation about the results of the election. In this case, assume more than 50 million people vote for election, give vote. And it is not available to apply a survey to whole population. It is very huge. Yeah. And because of lack of the time, on the other hand, it is very pricey, it is very expensive. Mm. It is not available to do it. And therefore, the best way establishing a sampling group. Sampling group means just you are selecting some people, but it should be selected using some statistical methods, not just stay on the street at the corner of the downtown and grab some people and ask questions. This is not the selection method. There are a selection method which is called EPSM, E-P-S-E-M, EPSM. We will discuss about this issue later. Randomly, everybody should think, okay, I can be selected too. Randomly selection method. There are some methods too. We will discuss about this too. And this is the most convenient way to estimate the results of a survey, results of an election in advance. Okay, this is the population and sampling. Collect empirical data, what you are collecting from the people, and process the data. You have to handle with data. For example, you are grouping ages and then educational level. These are the data that you collected, and you can make some groups and discuss about them, and then analyze the data. After you did all of them, then you have to prepare a report about your findings. This is the research way. I hope, Bilyam, you understood my explanation.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes, sir.
Good. Now,
yes, sir.
About
yes, sir.
Level of measurement, we will continue with level of measurement. Interval, you understood the meaning of the level of interval, huh?
Yes, I understood about the template.
Yes, and the interval
yes,
is
I understood
your
about
grading
the
system. Your grading system can be reserved for interval level of measurement, because we are saying, okay, if someone earns a grade between 90 to 100, then his grade is A, excellent. If someone earns between 80 and 89, this is B. You see, we are making interval for it.
Yes.
And what about the ratio? What can you say
yes.
for ratio?
Right.
Tuana, do you have Something to tell about the ratio?
Yes, ratio.
For example, if I say, okay, my annual salary is double of Bilyamino. You see, this is a ratio. Just I have to be double or half of it, etc. This is a ratio.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, I explained this part of the slides. And now, yes.
For another lecture, if you send us a lectures before we start.
For another lecture, if you send us a lecture.
There is another lecture for you.
Better, I think.
No. I mean for all the students before we start. You send
no,
the lecture.
No, I mean for all the students before we start. You send the lecture. You can see the lectures online.
Because not just you see your phone.
What do you study?
Because you just you see your Joanna, just a moment. I want to check it whether or not you are registered to my psychology.
Yes, doctor, I registered and I send you homework.
Yes, yes, oh, great. Doctor, I registered and I send you homework.
I can see who have been registered. These are the members now.
Yes, yes.
Just a moment. And for example, Bilyamino, Sabir Said, Muhammad Lawan, and Twana is registered. Already we have four people. Actually, one student left, I think. Okay, you can see materials directly from my psychology webpage. For example, weekly, which kind of the topics will be studied are presented here. I want to give an example about today's lecture, week four, for example. Can you follow? Are you coming with me, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. For example, for statistics,
yes, sir.
I just explained research process, then operationalization and measurement, and then I will continue with sampling methods and reliability and validity, but I have to rush a little bit because of the time limit. And I have videos here too. And these videos have been recorded previously, and some of them are in YouTube, and some of them directly in Schoology. Therefore, you have two choices. Just you can connect to YouTube, or just you can download from Schoology environment. And every week, not every week, some weeks, we will have some homework. And for example, if I am click this item, then I can see. You see, Twana already Twana sent his homework. Thank you, Twana.
Welcome. Doctor, what's your page name in YouTube?
Welcome to
Doctor, what's your page name? Go to Asan Farol and you will follow my course contents there. I will upload my course contents there. And the other people, four people, should upload their homework too. And Twana, do not forget to upload your picture here too, because I want to see your picture here too. For example, if I am selecting this link, then I can see Twana's homework. Okay, Twana.
Okay, I will upload my photo.
okay, I will upload my photo.
Sir. Okay, sir.
Yes, I am listening to you.
Sir. Yeah, sir. What is
the
time for
something? The homework? Yeah, sir. What is the time for something? The homework?
For example.
Because I don't know that you have given us.
Just what I will tell you. March 19, passed. I mean, only Twana sent on time. The rest of you slept.
No, I didn't say that.
But you have to follow my instructions in the psychology. In the psychology, I am providing a lot of material, and you have to follow weekly, and please. Try to study on time. If you don't study on time, then the material will grow up, and later you will not be able to study clearly.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Now.
Thank you.